3 seed Scrappers at 4-6 against the 1 seed Rebels at 10-0. So we're trying to keep up our winning streak. Today we'll have a 5-inning game. It's going to be the run rule is 15 after 3 and then 10 after 4. And then the most a pitcher can pitch is 3 innings. So 2 pitchers have to pitch for each team to go the distance. And we have a 4v4 game. For the Rebels, we got Bryce, the team captain, Mason, Caden, and Hudson. And then for the Scrappers, they have their team captain for the day, Carter, because their other team captain, Burke, is going to make it. So they got Carter, Jacob, the newly added player, Paul, because I traded him from my team to them. And then they have Landon for them. So that's their roster. It's a good 4v4 game here today.
It's hype out here, guys.
It's very hype out here.
We're ready to go. We're ready to kick the shit out of them.
So now we're going to go down to the field for some player interviews. We're with here the team captain of the day, Carter Knott, the Scrappers. You know, you're average, one of the lower averages in the league. You got a couple home runs this year. You know, you're having a pretty decent year so far here as a rookie. So your first playoff appearance here, what are you looking to do here today?
Win.
Your win? You think that's going to get done today by you guys?
It's possible.
It's possible? You think it's possible? May I ask who's starting on the mound for you guys today?
Well, if it's not.
So Jacob will pitch if he gets it?
He can pitch it. But if it's not, we'll play it by ear.
Play it by ear? If he does start, you think you have a 80% chance of winning or what? 40. Alright, we're going to go to the next player. Now we're here with Paul Kircher from the Scrappers, a newly added player for them. You know, he used to be on my team. I traded him for a kid named Noah. He can't make it here today because he has work. So, what do you think you guys are going to be getting done today? You think you're getting the dub or what?
I don't know, honestly. I mean, we'll probably do all right. I will hold our own for sure.
You think you'll hold your own?
Yeah.
What do you plan to do at the plate? A couple home runs, a little base hits, or a walk?
Definitely a couple.
Walks, you think you'll get on the mound today?
Probably not.
Ask him how he feels about his former team.
How do you feel about your former team? You know, you just recently got traded. Are you taking that personal today?
That's just how it goes. That's how the game's played, you know. I'm ready.
You ready? So you got the third best ERA this year with 4.20. All right. You looking to lower it? Is it going to higher a little? You're just going to look to keep it right?
I'm looking to keep it right at 4.20.
Keeping it right?
I don't want to change it.
I think that's going to be pretty tough. You can do it.
For sure. I want to keep it right at 4.20. All right.
You're also, I think, tied the third.
Try to get my average up, but I'm not a power hitter kind of guy. I'm more of a base hit, you know. I'm more of a just get on base kind of
guy.
Gotcha.
All right. So the real question: are you guys winning?
We're beating
the
Chiefs. All right, we're beating the Chiefs.
You heard it. We're gonna go to the next interview with the Rebels. All right, we're now here with the last interview of the day, the year two, for pregame interviews. We have Caden Allen, arguably the MVP for this year. Leads the league in average, second in home runs, third in hits, looking to get back on top of number one. What are you looking to do?
Take home the chipper.
Take home the chipper? Mm-hmm. So you think you're getting rookie of the year, MVP, or all of it?
Taking that triple crown.
Triple crown, all right. So you're probably not pitching today. So Mason start. How do you feel about that?
He's going to start.
Very, very confident.
Very confident.
If he gets in trouble, we got to.
Gotcha. Final score predictions in this 5-inning game. All right, you heard it. We're going to go down to the field for first pitch.
I lost my best friend to 23. She left her body in Harvard above me. I saw no shadow. I looked around. Searched every building and home that I found. I saw no shadow. I felt the glow. The warmth inside me kept me afloat. Felt like heaven. I found my bones. friend to 23. She left her body in Harvard above me. Crying about me, it gained an angel. I lost a friend. I felt like dying again and again. I went through hell instead of death, but I keep fighting with each living breath. I saw no way out from where I stood. Felt like a fire burned me for good. Now you're gone, I'm alone. I guess it's time to get better.
Thank you. So you're here with the Scrappers, the Losers. They come in second place to end the season. Their final record was 4-7. So they go 4-7 on the year. Come in second place. They just missed it. So talk about the game. What happened? What didn't go your way today?
Well, I mean, Carter's the only one that's been on the team since the beginning of the season. I was on the team since, like, yesterday. So I didn't have super high hopes, but, you know, you gotta play to win, but, you know.
So you lost 9-0. Any expectations for next year?
You're on the Scrapper squad.
I'll be on the Scrapper squad. We're gonna bring it. We're gonna get an actually good team. And we're gonna actually come out and give ourselves a name, you know what I'm saying?
Gotcha, gotcha. Together. All right, you're a sub for today. You guys lost 9-0. You're playing for the Moccasins. You guys clearly suck. But for the Moccasins, any expectations for next year?
Fine. I love the confidence and the truthfulness behind that. Now we're gonna go to the winners, the Rebels.
So we're now here with the Rebels. This is our third year in a row. The third year of the league's been a thing, and we've won all 3 years. So we finished the year 11-0. We win 9-0. First, we're gonna talk to the starting pitcher. Pitches a shutout. I think 2 home runs. Talk to us.
You know, I didn't feel too confident going into this game. Never been a starter, always a closer, you know. But I faced all these guys before. I know to throw them, you know what to do. You know, in the situation was tight, and I handled that pressure. you know, we showed up, we showed out.
Yep, all right, now we talk to Caden. Questionably, if he could be MVP, you know, he's definitely in the race.
In the running,
he leads just about everything. What was going through your head on that final pitch and shook him out?
I think I was tossing my glove for
gotcha. So you were confident coming to this game. It was bad. 9-0. So next year, any expectations?
We're going 4-time World Series champions next year. We're going undefeated next year, too.
I'm taking MVP this year, next year, and we're winning the chipper.
Gotcha. All right, now we're here with Hudson Davis. Huddy. All right, this may be his last game as a Rebel, depending on if he's moving. He might not be able to make two games.
This is a sad day for us.
Sad day.
A lot of ups and downs.
All good things must come to an end. So Hudson, what was going through your head, you know, last game on the field? You know, what was going through your head? Alright, what was going through your head?
So really, I'm just like, last game, you got a home run from the last game. Proud to be a rebel.
Alright, so, you know, your last hit was unfortunately a ground out, but you hustled, and that's all that matters. We hustled in and outside of this stadium, alright? So now,
and if I am,
how do you feel about this?
Good, you know, unless you got that, it's going to be way tougher, to be honest, but I thought Scrappers were going to be good, and Moccasins, they were okay, but they weren't the best. If Brooks actually showed up, I feel like they would have had a better chance. Same thing with the Moccasins and the ALCS, but you know.
How do you feel you went to Woods this year? Obvious Cy Young.
I think I get Cy Young and maybe, I don't know, just won the World Series. It's the process for me.
Well, what are we thinking about World Series?
Mason Collins.
MVP right here.
Clap it up. Alright, we'll see you in the next video. Over the offseason, we might have scrimmages, 1v1s, and stuff like that. So we'll see you next year.
As the rain falls.